Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I am Lokesh. Today we are discussing the factor affecting human comfort. In previous video lecture, we discussed about thermal comfort conditions for human being. If you miss it, you can find the link in description. Thermal comfort condition is simply the condition in which a person feels neither too cold nor too hot, just comfortable. There are total 6 factors identified by American Society of Heating, Refrigerating and Air Conditioning Engineers, out of which 4 are environmental factors, includes air temperature, radiant temperature, air speed and humidity, while clothing metabolic rate are personal factors which affect human comfort. Dealing with various thermal conditions, our human body acts as a super automated machine which always tries to maintain body temperature close to feel comfortable. Generally 98.6 Fahrenheit. We humans have some natural controls with which we can able to do so. In hotter climate, body liberates sweat which moves to the skin surface and get evaporated to maintain comfortable body temperature. While in an extremely cold condition, our body starts shivering. Due to increased muscle activity during shivering, internal heat is generated to maintain body temperature in comfort zone. Everyone get goosebumps during winter because body hairs are fluffed up to provide better insulation to prevent heat loss to a cold environment, and our body can maintain a comfortable temperature. The another factor for human comfort is radiant temperature. It is a complex term defined as the uniform temperature of an imaginary enclosure in which radiant heat transfer from the human body is equal to radiant heat transfer in the actual non-uniform enclosure. In simple words, it is just a consideration of radiant heat transmitted to the body. We all feel comfortable near the heat source. But have you observed what it exactly matters? When we sit too close or too far, we are not comfortable. A specific distance from the heat source which gives us a comfortable feeling. The third factor affecting human comfort is air speed. According to ASHRAE Standards 55, it is the average speed of air to which the body is exposed with respect to location and time. Air velocity is an important factor in thermal comfort along with other factors. For an example, still or stagnant air in indoor environment causes people to feel suffocated, while a moving air in warm or humid condition gives people a soothing feel. High air speed usually leads to discomfort. Physical activity also increases air movement, so air velocity may be corrected to account for person's level of physical activity. The fourth one is humidity, usually referred in terms of relative humidity, which is the ratio of actual amount of water vapor in the air to the maximum amount of water vapor that the air can hold at same temperature. While the human body has sensors within the skin that are fairly efficient at feeling heat and cold, but relative humidity is detected indirectly. With high relative humidity, the air with high moisture content, heat loss to the surrounding decreases. On the other hand, very dry environment with relative humidity less than 30% is also uncomfortable one. The recommended value of indoor humidity in the range of 30 to 60% in the air conditioned building depending on the other factor involved in thermal comfort. Recently, the effect of low relative humidity and high velocity of air were tested on humans after bathing, and researchers found that low relative humidity leads to thermal discomfort as well as sensation of dryness and itching. Hence, it is recommended to keep relative humidity level higher in bathroom than other rooms in the house for optimum conditions. Moving towards personal factor which affects human thermal comfort, first is metabolic rate. The impact of metabolic rate on thermal comfort is very crucial. The more physical work we do, the more heat we produce. the more heat we produce, the more heat needs to be lost to remain in comfortable state. According to ASHRAE 55, metabolic rate is the level of transformation of chemical energy into heat and mechanical work by metabolic activities within an organism, usually expressed in terms of unit area of total body surface. It is expressed in MET units. The MET is accounted for the personal activity of occupant, where one MET is person at rest. A person's physical characteristics should always keep in mind when considering their thermal comfort. Factors such as their size, weight, age, fitness level, sex have an impact on how they feel, even if other factors such as air temperature, humidity and air velocity remains constant. The last factor which affects human comfort is clothing insulation. The thermal comfort is very much depend on insulating effect of clothing on the wearer. Wearing too much clothing or personal protective equipment may be a primary cause of heat stress, even if the environment is not considered warm or hot. If clothing does not provide enough insulation, the wearer may be at risk from cold injuries. The CLO is measure of thermal insulation provided by clothing. One CLO unit will maintain a person at 1 MET comfortable in an environment of 21 degrees Celsius and 50% relative humidity and at 0.01 meter per second of airspeed. Clothing is both a potential cause of thermal discomfort as well as a control to adapt climate conditions. You may add layers of clothing if you feel cold or remove layers of clothing if you feel warm. The balance of all six factors is important to attain thermal comfort. Thank you very much for watching my video. Hope you like it. Have a good day.